Okay, welcome to another edition of Cooking with K Saban. So today we are going to be making mabaw chimchu. Mabaw chimchu is a rice porridge, Cambodian style. It's pork and pork blood. But let's get started. Okay, so before we get started, okay, so we're gonna need rice. This is regular, plain old regular rice, white rice. And you're gonna need pork. And this is called pork belly. The reason why I'm using pork belly is because it's got three layers. It's like chicken. So it's got three layers. It's got fat, pork fat. And it's got the meat as well, so this is the best time to make this kind of soup. And also you're going to need pork blood. Okay, so pork blood, you can get this at the market. And I went to get it today, so it's the pork as well. You're going to need also onion. You're going to need pots. Big pot, depending on how big you want to be your friend or your family. In this case, this is going to be the size of my pot for serving today. It's going to be filled up to all the way to almost the pot. This is just a pan, a regular pan. This for is to fry the rice. Okay? So you can fry the rice, you'll know why. And we need a little pot as well. This little pot, what I'm going to use it for is to cook the pork blood. So we're going to cook the pork. We are going to use to cook the pork blood first before we mix it with the soup. Okay, so we're going to need one of these as well. Okay, so we have two pots, and one big one and one small one. And we've got a pan for frying the rice. Just the basic salt, sugar, MSG, and maybe a little fish sauce, and then let's see what else. And garlic. You're gonna need garlic as well too. So we got garlic here. So we're gonna go ahead and get started. So the first thing we do is we're gonna go ahead and soak the rice first. Okay, you want to soak it and get it wet for a little bit, and maybe about 15 minutes, okay, so soak it up. But the reason I'm soaking it right now is to get it moist up before I fry it, okay? So we're going to fry uncooked rice, okay? I'm going to do that. So I'm going to go ahead and soak it with water. I'm going to leave it here for now. Okay, we're going to go ahead and fill this pot with water. I'm going to fill it up about 3/4 full. Okay, fill it up about 3/4 full. Now the water is about 3/4. I'm going to go ahead and do that. And what I'm going to do is put cooking salt in the water. Just enough to get some flavor in there. And like I said, not too much. If you don't want it too much, you can always add to make it salty. So what I'm gonna do right now is go ahead and smash the garlic. Smash it up into small, make it just smash it up, and then put this into the soup. So we got garlic and we got salt. What I'm going to do is going to go ahead and chop some more of these garlic for when I fry the rice. When I fry it, I'm going to put some more garlic when I fry the rice, because I want the rice to smell good, to have some flavor to it. So frying this up. Okay, so I got the garlic, I did that a little bit. And we now just go ahead and clean this up. This is the pork. Clean it up. Okay, so this is the pork section by Jun. By Jun, and you know, it's got a lot of flavor to this because the fat of the pork. I'm going to chop it up, season in regular size, up and up. About 1 inch wide, chopping it up right now, and then I'm going to put it inside the pan, the pot. Put it inside the pot. And this is to make the soup. Look, go ahead and put all of it in. About 9, 10 pieces. And then go ahead and put it in. So we got the pork, the salt, and the garlic inside the pot. Okay. So that's that. Okay, and the next thing I'm going to do is go ahead and cook the pork blood. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and fill this pot, small pot, with water for about 3 quarter bowls again. And then we got the pot going. We got pork blood. So, you know, some people don't like the pork blood. I like it, but you can do without it. But a barbecue food without pork blood. Right? What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and get the pork blood. It's thick right now. It's almost like ice, it's frozen. So I'm gonna go ahead and chop it up to make it into 4 pieces. Looks like it looks like this. Then put it inside the pot. Okay. Go ahead and boil this and cook it. Okay, it's gonna take a while. Okay, while we're waiting for the pork to be cooked. And what I'm gonna do now, fry the rice. Okay, we're gonna fry the rice. So using